Welcome back, fight fans. Welcome the fuck back. Let's dig right into it. The top five welterweights today, and we have to start with Keith One Time Thurman at number one. And now I understand what a lot of people are saying. Why Keith Thurman? Well, let's break it down. Keith Thurman has the best resume at the welterweight division. He's an elite level fighter. He has an elite level skill set. He has a myriad of skills that he can turn to, and he has a lot of tools in a toolbox. So you have to give Keith Thurman all of his credit and just do when you look at him as a complete and whole fighter. He would be a challenge and hard for anyone in the welterweight division to beat, because not only does he has good boxing ability, has good power, and he has great lateral movement. So his style would pretty much be a problem for any welterweight today. He was the only welterweight since Floyd Mayweather to unify titles at the welterweight division. He has since lost one of those titles by basically relinquishing it. And since then, Sean Porter has taken that belt. But I have to give Keith Thurman his credit. He has the best resume. He has an elite level skill set. And we just want to see Keith Thurman fight the best. Now, as of right now, Keith Thurman can be overtaken by number one on our list, by the number two fighter on our list. And the number two fighter on our list is Terrence Bud Crawford. And the number two welterweight in the division has to be Terrence Bud Crawford, for the simple fact that Terrence Bud Crawford is an elite level fighter. He's pound for pound potentially the number one fighter in the world. And Terrence Crawford also is an undefeated world champion at 147 pounds. He's moved up in weight and stopped both of his opponents. You know, he's going to get a lot of hate for the guys he stopped. But, you know, these are guys that were both undefeated. And Jeff Horn was a world champion as well, regardless of how you see him. You know, Jose Benavidez is a guy that had been avoided. And let's cut the bull. There was nothing wrong with Jose Benavidez's legs. He was getting knockouts before he fought Terrence Crawford. Let's be unbiased. Terrence Crawford is an elite level fighter, and I think against any welterweight in the division, I think Terrence Crawford would beat. I think his hardest fight would be Keith Thurman. I think one of the easier fights would be against a guy like Errol Spence. And I know that's contrary to what many people think and believe, but I have to be honest and unbiased what I see. I think that Terrence Crawford is just too skilled of a fighter to fight a guy like Errol Spence, and it'd be a difficult fight. I think that Errol Spence is more of a one-dimensional type of fighter, and he cannot box anywhere near the level of a Terrence Bud Crawford. I think Terrence Crawford would take Errol Spence Jr. apart bit by bit. I think Terrence Crawford can easily be the number one fighter in division with a few more quality wins, or even a potential belt, another belt or unification. I think that just the fact that he's the boogeyman of 147, the fact that, you know, even Keith Thurman said, oh, I don't rate what Terrence Crawford's accomplished at 147. The reason why he doesn't rate it is because he doesn't want to fight him. You have to understand that Keith Thurman said this is a bounce back year, 2019, right? So if it's a bounce back year and you're talking about taking on older fighters like Manny Pacquiao, you're talking about taking on lesser fighters like Lopez and you know, even a potentially a Sean Porter, but you say you want to save the Crawford and Spence fight for 2020. Why is that? If Terrence Crawford is not a full-fledged welterweight, like you says, he's not a real threat, he hasn't proven anything, but he's a world champion, then go get that belt. If he's that easy, go get the belt. Because he knows he's not easy. He knows that'll be his most difficult fight, and he doesn't want to step in the ring with an elite level fighter like Terrence Crawford and lose. That's pretty much it. You know, he used to have the moniker, I have an O and I'm not afraid to let it go. Well, looks like he's pretty terrified of letting it go right now, because not only do I believe he's ducking Spence, I believe he's ducking Crawford as well. And that's sad, because I believe those would be two great fights to have in 2019. But I understand Keith Thurman is wanting to see how things play out over this year, see if anybody has any flaws that can be exposed or exploited, and then he'll want to step in the ring with those guys. So at this point, I definitely would rate any other fighter above Keith Thurman should they give me a little more in the welterweight division. But respect to Keith Thurman, he is still a top level fighter. I have to put Terrence Crawford at number two. He is the boogeyman of the division. No one on the PBC side wants to fight Terrence Crawford. No one. Errol Spence openly admitted he doesn't want to fight Terrence Crawford. Even Floyd Mayweather came out and spoke on behalf of Al Haymon and stated that we're not looking to make the Errol Spence versus Terrence Crawford fight. So I think we all know who the real boogeyman at 147 pounds is. Let's be honest and unbiased. Terrence Bud Crawford has to be number two on the list. The number three fighter on the list, I'm going to have to put at Errol Spence Jr. And the reason why I have to put it at Errol Spence Jr. is because after Terrence Crawford, he would probably be the most avoided fighter at 147 pounds. If you look at Deshaun Showtime Porter, who clearly doesn't want to fight him right away, And if you also look at a Keith Thurman, who feels the same way. So I give Errol Spence Jr. his credit in that regard. He's a very strong and powerful power puncher. He's a body puncher. He's not an elite level overall fighter, but he is an elite level body puncher. So I'll give Errol Spence Jr. his credit. He's a world champion. But names like Carlos Ocampo and Lamont Peterson are not going to push me over the edge and say, oh, Errol Spence Jr. is the baddest man in the division. I just don't see it. He's never displayed a skill set that shows that he can do elite level things. Basically, all he's done is the same thing that he's done in every fight: attempt to walk his opponent down. That is it. He's showed no other skill set. He showed no other facets. And the fact that he's being hyped by all these fanboys means nothing to me. At the end of the day, Errol Spence Jr. has to show me more than what he's shown. And I just haven't seen it from him. And I think Mikey Garcia will be a true test to him. And he may no longer be a champion after that fight, if we're being honest and unbiased. But coming in at number four on our list is Sean Showtime Porter. I like and respect Sean Showtime Porter. I think he's a good quality champion. I think he's a solid competitor. He's beat Danny Garcia, so that had to put him at number four. I think that Sean Porter would be a difficult fight for anybody, but I think because of his skill set, I think it'll be hard for Sean Porter to get a lot of wins because he's not a pure boxer. But I will tell you this, Sean Porter has shown improvement in every fight that he's had. So, you know, as much as I underrate Sean Porter, maybe he's the type of fighter that could come up with a surprising victory over any of the top fighters that we just don't see, because Sean Porter has an interesting style of fighting, and he showed that he could beat Danny Garcia. So I have to give him credit where credit is due, as being a newly crowned WBC world champion. He just has to take the fights and step in against the top guys. He's shown that he's willing to fight Danny Garcia and Keith Thurman, but not anyone else, and that's just not going to cut it. And number five on our list, I had a choice between Danny Garcia and Manny Pacquiao. And when I looked at these guys, I saw Manny Pacquiao destroy Lucas Matisse. And then I see Danny Garcia basically lose to Sean Porter. So then you have a toss-up, and you have to be honest and unbiased that Manny Pacquiao, even at an advanced age, he's still a threat and dangerous to anybody in the division. So I have to put him at number five on the rankings. And there's been talk of Danny Garcia potentially fighting a Manny Pacquiao. So I think that'll be an excellent, excellent fight. I think that's a 50-50 fight. But I also think that Manny Pacquiao's work rate may be too much for Danny Garcia. I think Danny Garcia's detriment to his entire game is that his work rate is not enough. He's not throwing enough punches, and that is ultimately costing him fights because he's not scoring enough because he's not throwing enough punches. He has to let his hands go more. He has to do more than just counterpunch. Let's just be honest and unbiased about what Danny Garcia has to do. He has to get a little more aggressive. I understand he's a pure counterpuncher, but he has to be more aggressive. He has to, for him and the sake of his career at this point. He has to show more. But once again, that's the IBFP's top five welterweights. Please share your list in the comments. I'll be sure to comment on you guys, see what you guys have, what you agree with, what you don't. And unbiased as always, it's the IBFP. Please share, like, and you must absolutely subscribe.